Hi, my name is Jerome, and I'm here to let you know that you can actually lead. Everybody that you see around can lead, including you listening to me right now. You're a leader, and you can actually lead. So let's get right into this. All right, so right now, we're going to look at a few things, and part of what we're going to look at will be on the acronym. We'll look at LEAD as an acronym. And when we say LEAD as an acronym, that means we're going to look at what L stands for. E stands for, A stands for, and D stands for as well. And you might ask, what am I going to get at the end of this? Amazing. You're going to get a lot. You're going to realize that even if you're sitting down right now watching this video, doing nothing with your life because you feel there's nothing you can actually do with your life, you realize there's a lot you have inside of you that needs to come out, and you don't need anything extra. What you have right now is all you need. So let's look at L, the letter L. The letter L, I'll tell you, stands for leverage. When we talk about leverage, I'm not going to bore you going into definitions and everything, but I'm going to make it very simple for you. Leverage, I will say, is something you know you can fall on, something that belongs to you, that is original with you, that you can actually fall on. A lot of people will tell you, but you've got this going for you. Why don't you leverage on it? But you say, but for me, I don't have anything going on for me. There's nothing for me to leverage on. But that's not true. You have a lot going on. What about your failures? Failures? Can I leverage on failure? Of course you can. There's a lot you can do with failure. And that's where a lot of people don't know. People think that all they need, first of all, is success. But that's not true. That's not true at all. Most people who have made it today have actually leveraged on their failures. I'm telling you the truth. People who have made it today leverage on their failures. So what about your failures? What about your pain? What about the pain that you have been through in your life and you're still going through right now? You can actually leverage on your pain. You don't have to waste your pain. You don't have to waste your failure. What about your disappointments? You've probably been through a lot of disappointments in your life, and you can do that. But let me show you briefly when we say failure, pain, you know, and all of that. Let's assume you're somebody who has been through sexual abuse. You've probably been abused sexually at some point in time in your life as a child. And then you find out that you feel very uncomfortable by yourself. You feel that, I've become so timid. I feel there's a lot I have to hide. I feel there's a lot of pain inside of me, a lot of regrets. And I feel that I have a lot of resentment towards the person or the people that abused me as a child. Now, that's where you may be wrong, because actually you can actually package all that so well and make it work for you. There's so many people right now who you find out there who are doing a lot with the experiences they've had in the past. And they're using it to help so many people right now to stand up. They're also using it to prevent other people from getting into the same experience. And so you tell them you don't have a job. Oh, but while you were abused sexually, you're being prepared for something. So you have a job. You've got something you can do with your life. So leverage on your pain. Leverage on your failure. Leverage on your past. Leverage on that which you probably think will amount to nothing. Be one of those people, one of those winners out there today who actually leveraged on everything that has made them to lose. And today they have become a winner for it, because they were able to heal. They were able to come out of it one way or the other. And they're able to now stand and let the whole world know that this is what they have become. This is what they have managed to become. And this is what they are doing with what had happened in the past, making the best out of it. So leverage. That's where we start from when you want to lead. If you want to lead, start with leveraging. Start with all that you've got. And like I told you, what have you got? You've got your pain. You've got your failure. You've got your losses. You've got everything you think you can never work with, or everything that you think will never work for you. Those things that you have despised and actually thought can never work for you, those are the same things that actually can work for you. Then we look at the second thing. What about the second, looking into the next acronym, the letter E? The letter E will say stands for expand. Now, by the time you're beginning to realize that, yes, I have been pained. Yes, I have lost. Yes, I have failed. And now you're beginning to realize that, but in the same place where I lost, I can find myself. In the same place where I've had pain, I can have a lot of gain. And in the same place where I've been so disappointed, I can begin to realize that there are so many appointments waiting for me out there. Because my experience is original. My experience is real. My experience is not the same like everybody else. It is very personal. And I'm going to use it to lift myself instead of have myself fall into the pit. So right now, when you're beginning to do that, the next thing you realize is, expansion begins to come. Your mind begins to blow up. You realize that something is beginning to change in your life. And you begin to realize that, yes, you want to get out there. You don't want to hide anymore. If all you've been doing before is hide, stay indoors, you realize you don't want to hide anymore. You want to move out there right now and begin to try out your hand on certain things. You failed before. You're not afraid of failures anymore. You've been through pain. And I'll tell you the truth. The last thing you're afraid of right now is pain. You're no longer afraid of pain. And you've been disappointed before. So you are no longer afraid of this being disappointed again, because right now you know that the best is yet to come, and that's what you're going out for. And that way you realize that expansion begins to come into your life. You begin to move out of your room where you've probably been staying all your life. Move away. I mean, that place you've been hiding, you find that you don't want to hide anymore. You want to get out there right now and begin to show yourself. And I tell you the truth, you have a lot to show concerning yourself. So much to show, so much that is original with you, that you have to show the world. And only you, it's peculiar with you. Only you can actually make the people see the way you see it. Even if a lot of people have been through that, the way you are going to show it is unique. And so the world needs you. The world needs you to come out right now. And that's where your expansion begins. So what we've said so far, that looking at the acronym, LEAD will make you begin to leverage. Now, we've also talked about the fact that E stands for expansion, and now you begin to expand. By the time you begin to expand, the next thing you will see begin to happen to you is the letter A, and that is accelerate. You'll begin to move forward now, push forward right now. You actually begin to accelerate. You'll realize suddenly you're not where you used to be. Because you realize that you're beginning to, the more you expand, the more you become more confident in yourself. And as you become more confident, you begin to actually accelerate, move forward. Now you believe in yourself, you believe in what you've got, and you believe in what you have to offer the world out there. And so you begin to accelerate and begin to move on and on and on. Now, but with speed, because what you probably would have in the process of expanding, what you would have done in 3 hours, at this time, because you're becoming more experienced in your forward movement, you realize that you can actually do what you used to do in 3 hours. You can do it in 30 minutes because you have experience right now at what you're doing. And so you begin to accelerate. And as you begin to accelerate, you find that amazing things begin to happen. At this point in time, your world is opening up. The world is also opening up to you. People are looking for you. People are beginning to realize that they need you right now because you actually have something to offer. And the next thing you move into at this point is, we look at the letter D. You begin to dominate. Dominate here means you begin to stand in your own ground and take over. Now, you are no longer asking for to actually stand in the ground of other people. You're not actually trying to move into the brands of other people to make it in life. You become a brand on your own and you begin to dominate. You begin to take over what you should have taken over a long time ago. Remember where we started from? Where you used to just sit down and you used to just live in regrets and you used to just moan and think there's nothing good about your life. Not realizing that same thing that used to despise so much is actually the treasure in you that has now brought you out. So right now you have your own ground. You have become a brand of your own and you begin to dominate. And so you can lead. Everybody can lead. Now, the question I have for you today, and I want you to actually think about this, and then we can continue this on the social media and on this particular channel Jerome is talking. The channel is out there, which all you need to do is click on it and subscribe to it, and then we can continue this on the social media. So what you need to do right now is ask yourself, what are the things that I can actually leverage upon? Now, don't be afraid to write the most terrible things about your life down. Even if at a point in time you used to steal, write it down. I used to steal. Now you actually know how you can figure out who is stealing out there and why the person can stop and how the person should stop and how you can stop anybody from stealing from other people. So you've got, write it down. Don't be ashamed of it. Now write it down. What has caused you shame in the past is now what is bringing you fame at this point in time. Now my name is Jerome and this is Jerome is Talking. Don't forget to subscribe on the channel and we'll be glad to continue this with you. Thank you.